Welcome to lecture number 4 on mechanisms. So far in the previous lectures we discussed about mechanisms which can generate quick return motion, right? So in this lecture we will start with few mechanisms which can generate straight line, right? So mechanisms which are designed to produce straight line motion, we simply call them as straight line motion mechanisms, right? So any mechanism with a sliding pair, right, it becomes a classic example for a straight line mechanism. But they are very bulky, they wear rapidly, right, and they are constrained, right? So, and they are not so convenient, right? So often we require a mechanism wherein turning pair is used to generate a straight line, right? So that is what we are exactly looking on to here. So these straight line mechanisms are used in steam engines or any other engines to indicate the engine pressure, right? So that is exactly why we make use of them. So we can have a point that moves exactly along a straight line or nearly along a straight line depending on the need. So we can call it as an approximate straight line producing mechanism or an exact straight line producing mechanism. So we will see one example for each, right? And one of the examples for a mechanism which can generate approximate straight line is a Roberts approximate straight line mechanism. So this is how it works. So it's nothing but a simple 4-bar mechanism, right? At the center of the coupler we are going to drop down a link, right? So when it and the projection, the path traced by that point, end point, will be nothing but a straight line. So this is only approximate and not an exact straight line mechanism, right? So that is what you can appreciate here. We have something, I have given 180 degree motion to the input link. So as the 4-bar mechanism begins to rotate, right, we can see that the point H almost traces a straight line, right? So we will go back to see how the construction is going to happen, and we will see few examples for the Roberts approximate straight line mechanism. So this is how exactly the construction takes place. So we have point O and point A which are fixed, OC and AD are the cranks, CD is a coupler, right? OC may complete a 360 degree rotation or may not complete a 360 degree rotation. Exactly at the center of CD I have a point D, from where I have suspended a link BE, right, which is perpendicular to CD. That is the thing. So now when C moves to C dash, right, when C moves to C dash, D moves to D dash, we observe that B moves to B1 or B moves to B dash, right? So when B moves to B dash, we observe that E moves to E dash, and E travels along approximately a straight line, right? And I say that this is the locus of E. We can observe that locus of E is nothing but an approximate straight line. Right. So that is a basic concept of a Roberts approximate straight line mechanism. This is a very simple mechanism, right? So we can observe a small video here which lets us know how exactly it works. So it is a very simple mechanism. A link has been suspended exactly at the center. So when you try to move that, approximately you are going to generate a straight line mechanism. Right. This is one more example for the straight line mechanism. You can just appreciate. So you can see that instead of dropping a single link, we can have a ternary link shown as a blue color, right? So also approximately it generates a straight line here, right? So now we have mechanisms which can generate exact straight line, right? One such example is a Posillier's exact straight line mechanism, right? So this is how the Posillier's exact straight line mechanism is going to work. In case of Robert, it was only approximate. I could approximate that a straight line is generated, but now I want exactly a straight line to be generated. We make use of a Posillier's mechanism, right? Now we will go back to go and see how the construction working principle of a Posillier mechanism, as well as the proof for it, right? The proof that it generates only straight line and nothing else. Right. So this is the construction features. What we have to observe is that, right, the link OA here, the link OA and OE, right, so geometrically they should be same, and the link AD and AB, so this is the link AD and this is the link AB, so they should be similar to each other. And all the four links of a rhombus, that is BE, BC, CD and ED. They should be similar to each other. The same thing you can appreciate in the color coding of the animation that has been shown. Right? So the one that are shown in the green color will exactly be the same. The one that are shown in the blue color will have the exactly same dimension, and all the four links of a rhombus will have the same dimension geometrically. Right? So AO will be equal to OE, AB and AD will be equal to each other, BE, ED, DC and BC, right, will be similar to each other. So this link OE, right, will be able to, or point E will be able to complete 360 degree rotation, or it is a link which can rotate more. Instead of 360 degree, I can simply say that point E can rotate. Right? So the same thing has been shown here. The path traced by point E has been shown here, and wherever it intersects the horizontal, I am going to call it as F, and it exactly intersects the horizontal at the another point exactly at A. So now I know that OA, OE are equal, AB, AD are equal, and all the four sides of a rhombus are equal to each other. Now we will make few geometrical changes here. I am going to draw a line, right? I am going to draw a line to connect E and F, right? And at the same time, I am going to draw a line to connect A to C, right? B to D and E to C, right? Wherever BD intersects EC, I am going to call that line as L, right? So now we will see, right? So this is called as C, this is called as C1. Right? So C, when it moves to C1, it should move exactly along a straight line. That is the concept of the Posillier's mechanism. Now we will see a small proof that Posillier mechanisms generate only straight line and nothing else. Right? To go for that proof, let me join BD to bisect EC at L. So this is EC, this is BD. So both are intersecting at point L. Right? So from the right angle triangle, ALB and CLB. So this is A, this is point L, and this is B. So this is one of the right angle triangle, ALB. And similarly, I have one more right angle triangle, CLB. So this is point C, this is point L, this is B. So this is one more right angle triangle. So I have two right angle triangles, ALB as well as CLB. Let me apply Pythagoras theorem to it. For the right angle triangle ALB, AB is the hypotenuse. For the right angle triangles CLB, BC, right, will be the hypotenuse. So square the remaining two sides, AL square. So this will be the AL square plus BL square. So similarly, CL square plus BL square. So one is called as equation 1, another one is called as equation 2. Now subtracting equation 1 from equation 2. So I have made a small change here. So subtracting equation 1 from equation 2. So AB square minus BC square. So BL square, they cancel out. So AL square minus CL square. I know the formula for A square minus B square. Right? A square minus B square can be simply written as A plus B into A minus B. So similar thing I apply for AL square minus CL square. They can be written as AL plus CL, AL minus CL. So coming back to geometry, we will explore what is AL plus CL. So this line is AL and this is CL. So AL plus CL is nothing but AC. Now we will see what is AL minus CL. Right? So now I know that all the four sides of a rhombus are equal. So CL and EL should be equal to each other. Right? So instead of calling it as AL minus CL, I can also call it as AL minus EL. That is this line. Right? So AL minus EL gives me AE. So that is what has been shown here. So AB square minus BC square will be nothing but product of AC into AE. Right? But we know that the link AB and the link BC are of constant length. When the mechanism begins to generate, they are going to remain as rigid links. Their dimensions are not going to change. So this is the link AB, this is the link BC. Right? That is what we have on the left hand side. So AB square minus BC square is shown as AC into AE. When the dimensions of AB and BC are not going to change, when they are of constant length, the product of AC and AE should also remain constant. It cannot change. So I say that product of AC and AE will be equal to constant, because on the other side I have AB square minus BC square, right? And they are not going to change. This remains a constant. So hence I say that whatever the path that the point C is going to trace, right, when it moves along, that should be perpendicular to the diameter AF. So this is the diameter AF I have here. So it is perpendicular to it, right? And it should be a straight line. So that is what the Fusilier mechanism says. This is the proof that Fusilier mechanisms generate only straight line mechanism. So this is another configuration to see. So this is the original position. Now it has moved from point 1 to point 2 and it has traversed exactly along a straight line. Right? This is one more example of a Fusilier mechanism. You can appreciate that. It is comprised only of turning links when there are no sliding pairs involved here. So we can appreciate that the dimension this and this will be equal to each other, right? Similarly, this length and this link length will be equal to each other and all the four sides of a rhombus are equal. So we appreciate that the output by a Fusilier mechanism will be an exact straight line. So we can appreciate the animation one more time. The links in the green color will be equal in length. The links in blue color will be equal in length. And links in red color will be equal in length. In such a case, they are going to generate an exact straight line. So this is the constructional feature consisting only of turning pairs. Right? So that's the end of lecture 4, wherein we came to know about mechanisms that generate straight line. Thank you.